Appearances can be deceiving. These two bricks look pretty similar. Maybe one's a little bigger when I just show them to you. But if you actually pick them up, you'd realize that they're completely different. One is extremely heavy, while this one isn't even a brick at all. It's not that what you see visually is wrong, it's just incomplete information. You can't tell how heavy something is just by looking at it. You need to take a different approach to answer that question. The same thing happens when we're trying to understand how people interact with complex interfaces. If we only consider one type of information, we're leaving out a lot of the story. So a better strategy is to triangulate and use multiple different methods of investigation. Triangulation just means you look at something from more than one angle or point of view. It doesn't have to be overly complicated. For example, if you're getting user complaints about a feature being difficult to use, before you jump ahead with a redesign, stop and check your analytics data to see if it's consistent with the problem that you've received reports about. Sometimes people report the symptom of a problem instead of the root cause, and triangulation can help you detect what's really going on. You can triangulate by looking at multiple sources of information, such as surveys and interviews. Multiple types of information, like pairing qualitative usability testing with quantitative analytics data, or by getting multiple interpretations of information when you ask different experts to review the same data and see if they come to the same conclusions. All of these techniques will help with more accurate understanding of UX problems and with designing better solutions.